What's going on, everyone? Welcome back to Jared T Productions. Now, today we're going to be talking about the famous social media app called TikTok. If you have not heard of it, well, you have been living under a rock. That social media platform actually started in 2013 in Beijing, China, but only Beijing, China. And it wasn't until around 2018 when it merged with Musical.ly. Now, that's another social media platform. Now it's actually TikTok. So it's kind of one platform now, but that also was a massive platform with TikTok. They combined and made this gargantuan platform known as TikTok. At the end of 2018, after the social media platform TikTok had combined with Musical.ly, it was the number one most downloaded app. And around 2019, a little after a year after launch, it was the seventh most downloaded mobile app of the decade, not of the year, of the decade, from 2010 to 2019. So just like any other app, TikTok uses artificial intelligence, just like YouTube does your recommendations of videos, Instagram does your recommendation of posts that you liked. So TikTok basically does the same. It kind of puts together all the videos that you like, all the videos that you comment on, the most recent ones you search up, and the ones, of course, you spend the most time on, because just like any other platform, they want you to stay on their platform for a long time. So this is where it gets nasty. So June of this year of 2020, President Trump had a campaign rally right here in my hometown of Tulsa, Oklahoma, here at the BOK Center. But it was believed that many TikTok users kind of mistreated the whole system that was used to reserve tickets to go to the rally. They apparently just, I'm not sure what specific group in TikTok or how it works, but somebody from TikTok, like a bunch of kids probably, created these fake accounts to make it seem like they were a lot more reserved for the event than there actually were. Long story short, at the end of the day, the BOK Center was nowhere near the 1 million people that they thought would be coming, because those were fake accounts. So there's one of the blows that caused this issue about potentially banning TikTok here in the US. By now you should know that TikTok is banned in China, I believe in India, and slowly being banned in other parts of the world. US is obviously the next one that is thinking about banning, and that's why I made this really short video to kind of explain a little bit, first off, of what TikTok is, some of the negative effects that it's had, and what will my opinion be of the platform if it shuts down or if it doesn't shut down. So one more quick thing that I want to add is, of course, cyberbullying. There's a lot of young users on the platform, and I'm not saying everyone uses it bad, but again, just like Facebook, Instagram, there are sexual predators out there, and I think, like, TikTok hasn't been the best when it comes to tightening accounts. Instagram has been ahead of the game. Facebook also has done a really fantastic job at trying to block a lot of those spam and a lot of those sexual predator accounts. Now on TikTok's side, since it's still such a very new app and it grew rapidly, I can imagine it's very hard to keep track of that. So I'm not giving hate to them, but that is something they definitely have to be looking at, especially the demographics of TikTok. It's just extremely young, little boys and little girls on the platform. So that's definitely something to look at if you're a parent. But that's just my two cents on this TikTok app. I didn't want to bore you or give you an insane amount of info, which you could find online, more information about TikTok if you want to learn more. I just wanted to give you guys the basics about the app and just a little bit of my info and input as to what I think of the app. If it does shut down or if it doesn't, in my opinion, I'm kind of neutral. I've been on TikTok a few times. I don't post anything. I just see a lot of big celebrities' pages, basically, is what my feed is filled up with. And yeah, I can definitely see why it is just like another social media platform. It's extremely addictive. You spend countless hours and hours and hours there, which is definitely not a way to spend your time. But recently with this whole COVID issue, I can imagine their numbers have grown dramatically because everyone's staying at home. Kids aren't going out as much. So it's definitely something to be cautious of. You don't want to spend too much time on the platform. But again, just like any other social media platform, if this does go down, there will probably be another version of TikTok out there, just kind of like Flappy Bird. If you guys remember the old game Flappy Bird on the iOS store, it was up for a while, maybe a few years, it went down, and other versions came up. There'll always be a new version of a social media platform try to compete with Facebook and Instagram and Snapchat and Twitter. TikTok's just trying to be one of those guys. So great idea and everything, but it is definitely something we don't really need. So you put down your opinion down below. I'd be more than happy to listen to see what you guys have to say about TikTok. But yeah, again, that's my two cents. So whatever happens to the platform, happens to the platform. But other than that, I hope you guys have a great day, a great week, or a great weekend, depending on when you're watching this video. And I will see you guys in the next one. Peace.